Dear Ecosians, welcome to this 25th tree update. And to celebrate this milestone and also the fact that the tree team has been growing, I want to use this update to give you an insight behind the scenes on how we plant and monitor your trees. So how do we keep track of all these millions of trees your searches help us plant? Let me give you an example. Last December, we were in Brazil, monitoring some of the trees that had been planted by you 2 years ago. What you see in this video is me typing in a specific number of trees growing on this site, together with Joachim from our partner organization Sipan. 2 years ago, we signed a contract with Sipan to plant trees for us on this specific site, because that is where it all starts with, by signing a contract. We signed this so-called service contract through which we hire planting organizations to plant a certain amount of trees for us. To date, we have signed over 80 contracts, which is why I needed a bigger team. Let me introduce you to Melissa.
So to set up a contract, what I do is that I enter all the variables that we have agreed with a partner. I'm going to show you here an example that we have with our partner in Brazil, Sipan, where Peter went to visit Joachim last December. So what I do is I enter all the variables, which are, for example, the price per tree, the number of trees which are going to be planted over the project, also the locations, but also very importantly, the tree species. So the contract is actually the end of a long discussion that we have with our partners. And what we are trying to do here is trying to look at a bigger picture, at a larger scale, if those trees that we are planting are actually having a broader impact for the farmers' communities. But this is actually beyond the trees, and this is where we hand it over to Katharina.
Exactly, that is my job, to make projects more socially sustainable, to make sure that the farmers get a higher income from products like oil, for instance. We produce moringa oil in some projects, and that allows farmers, by picking the fruits from the trees, to make a higher income. And we can also produce things such as coffee in between the rows of trees. And that completes the contract, because we can make sure that the farmer earn more and that there will be more trees planted by the projects.
All these contracts with information about which tree species we plant and when is the planting season in each country is saved in a database. And this allows me, for example, to track milestones when we can expect videos or pictures of your trees being planted, which I then share with you in my tree updates. This requires us to be constantly in touch with all of our partners. We do this mainly through WhatsApp groups, and that's what Antonia takes care of.
We currently have over 25 active contracts. This means that we have more than 25 partners with whom we're planting trees or planning to do so over the next few months. It's really important for us to keep track of what's going on the ground. That's what the WhatsApp groups are for. This allows us to share videos, photos, and updates with our partners, but also the kinds of problems that they encounter. For example, flooding, sandstorms, and all kinds of things, and most recently, how they're dealing with the lockdown. The partners also always send me their invoices, which I then book into our system, so then we can report back to our users how much money we are spending on tree planting every month. In these invoices, we also see the exact numbers of trees that have been planted, which I then share these with Edmund, who you know from tree update number 20.
When a partner has planted trees for us, they share the location of the planting areas, the number of trees they planted, and the tree species they planted. They also take photos of the planting sites. Then they send all this data to us, and we store it in our database. At present, we have around 6,000 planting locations in our database. To help our partners make it easier to send the data to us, we use an app, ACFO. They can use ACFO to fill in all the data of the planting sites or nurseries, and after filling in the form, they send it to our cloud database by one press on the button. So now we all have all this data from our planting partners. I can actually show each planting location on a satellite image. So now, Peter, I can point out exactly where you were during your last visit in Brazil.
Thank you, Edmund. This is really the backbone of what we're doing. It's incredibly important to Ecosia to know exactly where our trees are planted and where they're growing. And therefore, because of all your work and all your searches, we now have probably the largest restoration database in the world, and it will be ever growing. So that's it. Once my team helped me to get all the details right, from signing the contract to knowing where the trees have been planted, we then decide which of the projects are ready for another visit from us. And this is what I was showing you at the beginning, where I was measuring the trees we planted together with Joachim. I hope this video gives you a good insight on how we work with our partners and how we keep track of where we plant our trees. At the next tree update, I will discuss individual projects again. Thank you.